The differential is a component that allows the wheels of your vehicle to spin at different speeds so it can turn corners. If a vehicle only ever traveled in a straight line, there wouldn't be a need for a differential. But because a vehicle must be able to turn, a differential is required. The differential was founded in 1827 by a Frenchman. First used in steam-driven vehicles, the differential became a standard component of vehicles with internal combustion engines since then. A differential has three functions. One is to transfer the power from the vehicle's engine to the wheels. Two is to slow the rotational speed of the transmission before it goes to the wheels. Three is to transmit the power to the wheels while allowing them to turn at different speeds. When power is transmitted to a pair of wheels, the force is divided equally between them, but for the vehicle to turn, the inside and outside wheels must spin at different speeds as they are traveling different distances around a corner. The inside wheels travel a shorter distance than the outside. The differential is a combination of gears designed to work together to minimize the loss of drive to one side of the vehicle when it turns a corner. To better understand how the gears work together to create different wheel speed, here is visual explanations. When a car moves in a straight line, the engine provides power through the driveshaft into the differential, which divides the power between the two rear wheels. This propels the car along, and so the wheels will all rotate at the same time at the same speed. However, when a car turns, the front two wheels change direction, but the rear wheels remain in position. The wheels are now following different length paths. The inner path is shorter than the outer path. So the outer wheels must cover a longer distance in the same amount of time. And that means they need to rotate faster. So the rear wheels need to turn at different speeds. The differential allows the wheels to rotate at different speeds. If this wasn't installed, then both wheels would rotate at the same speed on corners. And this would cause the tires to slip and wear out. The car would become harder to handle and the forces could even snap the axle. Therefore, we allow the rear wheels to rotate at different speeds to stop that occurring. We can see from this basic model differential that if I hold one of the wheels, the other can still rotate. Let us look at the main parts of a rear differential. First, we find the main housing, which surrounds all the internal components. Somewhere on the casing, there will be a removable plate, allowing access to the internal gears. The casing stops debris from the road, damaging the internal gears. It also retains oil within the housing to lubricate the gears and reduce wear. If we remove the housing, we can see the various gears which are attached to the axles. These are supported by a number of bearings to ensure a smooth rotation. The engine will provide power via the input gear, which is known as the drive pinion gear. The pinion gear connects to the ring gear, which is much larger. Notice the gears are spiral cut. They could be straight cut, but a spiral cut increases the contact surface area. In this example, we have 43 ring teeth and 11 pinion teeth. And so the ratio is about 3.9 to 1. A low ratio increases the fuel efficiency, but it decreases acceleration. A high ratio decreases fuel efficiency, but it increases acceleration. So car designers need to take this into consideration. The ring gear is mounted to the differential casing. This then supports two smaller internal gears known as the spider gears. The spider gears are often joined with a small metal shaft. When the ring gear rotates, the spider gears will travel around the same axis. However, the spider gears can rotate on their own axis. We use two spider gears to distribute the forces evenly. The spider gears connect with two other gears known as the side gears. One connects to the left wheel axle and the other connects to the right wheel axle. the spider gears will allow the axles to rotate at different speeds, while still transferring torque and rotation to the wheels. There are three types of differential. 1. Open differential. 2. Limited slip differential and 3. Torque vectoring differential. Let us start to discuss the first type, open differential. We can see how all gears are linked together. Here the propeller shaft drives the pinion gear. Pinion gear drives the ring gear or crown gear. Final gear reduction happens here. Crown gear hub rotates along with the crown ring. These little gears, also known as spider gears, are installed on it. So it can spin on its axis and also can rotate along with the crown gear rotation. These two are sun gears. Sun gears are in gear mesh contact only with the spider gears. So spider gears rotation makes it rotate too. Each sun gears are connected with its respective side drive axle. Drive axle makes the wheel rotate. On a straight road, when both wheels has same amount of traction, spider and sun gears unit rotate as a single unit. So both side wheel rotates at same speed. But during making a turn, outside wheel has to cover more distance than inner side wheel. That means, outer side wheel has to rotate faster to make smooth turn. This differential unit makes it possible. While following the curved path, inner side wheel develops more friction between road and tire. So inner side wheel, as well as the side sun gear, tries to slow down. But in order to maintain crown gear rotational speed, spider gears start rotating on its axis. Spider gear's rotation provide additional rotation to the opposite side sun gear. So this is how outer side axle rotates faster than inner side axle. This helps non-steerable rear wheels to follow cornering line smoothly. The problem with open differentials is that they send power to the wheel with less friction, which causes the wheel to slip. We need a slightly different design that limits the slip of the wheel with less friction. So we use a limited slip differential. The clutch-based version is probably the most common. So we will learn how this works. With the limited slip differential, we have the same main components: the drive pinion, the ring gear, the casing, the spider gears, the side gears and the axles. However, we do have some additional parts. Behind each side gear, we find a clutch pack, which consists of multiple layers of two different discs. We have the clutch friction plates and the clutch discs. The clutch friction plates have a special textured surface which increases friction. Part of the disc extends outwards. This will slot into the grooves of the differential case. When the ring gear rotates, it rotates the casing, and so the clutch friction plates will also rotate. The clutch discs are sheets of metal with teeth around the inner edge. These will slot into the splines of the side gears, interlocking the two together. When the side gear rotates, the clutch disc rotates also. However, the clutch friction plates do not interlock with the splines of the side gears. and so they will rotate around it. These two discs are stacked alternatively to form the clutch pack on each side. A spring is then inserted into the middle, which provides a light pushing force. And so the side gears will slightly compress the clutch packs. The friction material of the clutch plates will grip onto the clutch discs. This will temporarily join them together. And so they will rotate together. However, if a certain amount of force or torque is applied to the wheel, then the two discs will break this temporary joint and slip past each other. So when the car turns, the wheels have to change speed. This will provide enough force to break the temporary joint, and so the side gears can rotate at different speeds, although the main casing will continue to rotate at the same speed. However, when the car travels in a straight line, the friction between the clutch packs temporarily locks the side gears so that they rotate at the same speed. The main casing will rotate with them and provides the pushing force. So with the limited slip differential, when a car travels across a slippery surface, the power of the engine is distributed to both wheels so the car gets some traction and is able to continue forwards. But this isn't possible with an open differential, and so the vehicle will become stuck. This type of differential uses a set of sensors and electronics to receive data from various matters. Road surface, throttle position, steering system, etc. to activate an electronically actuated clutch and a controller. They operate in the most efficient manner, resulting in a truly dynamic high-performance driving experience. A torque vectoring difference type is found in high-performance rear-wheel drive and all-wheel drive vehicles. Full-time four-wheel drive and all-wheel drive have three differentials. One in front axle, second in rear axle, and third differential is in the middle of drivetrain, which allows the wheels to turn at the different speeds. It enables complete control by the designer. The system can choose under what conditions the vehicle will send more torque to any one wheel rather than being reactive. It can send up to 100% of the potential torque to a wheel. Though it does not have any drawbacks, it hits two things which are cost and complexity. The torsion means torque sensing. These are types of limited slip differential that use some accelerated gearing to produce an impact without using a clutch or fluid resistance. This can be achieved by adding a collection of worm gears to a conventional gear setup of the open differential. These worm gears working on each axle provide the necessary resistance to enable torque transfer. This is achieved by having the worm gears in a continuous mesh with each other through connected spur gears. The continuous mesh between the two sides of the differential has the advantage of delay. As soon as there is a speed difference between them, it starts sending more torque to the slower wheel. Also, it reacts far more quickly than limited slip differential. These systems do not require regular maintenance because differential action is dependent on friction throughout the gear. When a wheel is in the air, a torsion differential works similar to an open differential, and very little torque is transferred to the drive axle. This is perfectly acceptable for road use, but it can be an issue for more purpose-built vehicles on the track. However, what do you think about these different types of differentials? Which one is the best? What are your thoughts? Tell me in the comments below, then please give it a like, and click subscribe button to this my channel Otoinsightbro. Thank you for your watching and your support.